Heart of New York City. Every boxer's dream is to play the Garden. Tonight, celebrating St. Patrick's Day, we play the theater of Madison Square Garden. It's fight night. This lad has Irish boxing fans jumping for joy. John Duddy's fast hands and powerful punches have led to a brilliant beginning to his career. A career that was born in Ireland and has blossomed on this side of the pond. Tonight, he enters boxing's mecca, dreaming of a 14th knockout in his 16th fight. The breakthrough bout every champion has is tonight. He hopes to keep the Irish eyes smiling. From the heart of New York City, it's fight night. Elbowing their way in, there's some of those smiling Irish eyes. They are all wearing the green tonight. Look at there, even the billboard of Madison Square Garden is green. Madison Square Garden Boxing in association with Irish Ropes Promotion presents Fight Night. Hello again, everyone. I'm Sean O'Grady, and this is Irish Mickey Ward. We're here to talk to you about this fight tonight. We both fought on St. Patrick's Day. I did, and you did as well, Mickey. What does it mean for every young Irish boxer to be able to fight on St. Patrick's Day?
Well, it means a lot, Sean. It means everything. St. Patty's Day, being Irish, the crowd gets into it. But you just can't get into the crowd. You can't let the crowd play. You have to just fight your fight, be calm, and fight the best fight you can possibly fight.
And that crowd, and being a St. Patrick's Day fight, everyone seems to fight above their ability. Tonight, we've got a pair of middleweights. Look at there, John Duddy from Northern Ireland looking for his 16th professional win. He's going up against Shelby Pudwill. This should be a terrific middleweight fight. In fact, look at the history of the middleweight division and who has fought here in the Garden. Look at that. The very first event at the Garden, at this modern Garden, was a middleweight championship fight. How about those names, Mickey?
It's incredible. You got the Hagler, Monzones, Griffin, Fulmer. It's just incredible.
And the middleweight division is arguably the most exciting in boxing. The power of the heavyweights, the speed of the lighter weights. What do you look for in this matchup tonight, Mickey?
Well, I look for John Duddy to start fast, Sean. And I look for Pudwill to box a lot at the beginning. But tonight, the Irish eyes will be on John Duddy. So John's going to have to go out there and do what he does best, and that's win the fight.
Oh, yeah, and Duddy is one of those fighters who starts fast. He likes to get him over fast. He's very exciting to watch. The third member of our broadcast team is also exciting to watch, Tony Page.
Thanks very much, Sean. Another fighter we should keep an eye on is James Moore. 300 amateur fights from Ireland. He was John Duddy's roommate back in the amateur days in Ireland. And another fighter on the card tonight is female fighter Maureen Shea. And Maureen, must be a little bittersweet for you because you lost the last time you fought here in the Golden Gloves. Now as a professional, what's going through your mind right now?
I'm excited. I'm really excited. I'm taking that experience from the Golden Gloves into my fight tonight. Being here in Madison Square Garden, and it's wonderful for me with less than a year later to be able to fight here. And I'm looking forward to it. I'm very excited, calm, relaxed, and ready to go.
You did a lot to help Hilary Swank win her Oscar, $1 Million Baby. Is that behind you, or are you still part of you right now?
Oh, it's always going to be part of me. That was a wonderful experience. I mean, just with the movie and just being a part of it and meeting Hilary and having her influence my life and my boxing as she has, it's definitely with me. And I take it into the ring with me every time I fight.
What can we expect when you go in the ring tonight?
Expect a good show. I don't go in there thinking too much. I go in there, I see what I got in front of me, and I put on a good show. So we'll see what happens. Whatever comes out, comes out.
Thanks very much, Maureen. Now let's get this show started. We got a lot of fights tonight, so sit back, relax, get comfortable.
Working from home changed my life.
It all started when I was referred by this free service.
All you need is a computer and a little belief in yourself.
With all the money I made working from home, I bought a new home. This is the one website you have to visit.
I love the lifestyle my home business offers, and the money's great too.
If you're not working from home, then you're missing out on your share of a multi-billion dollar industry.
I make over $7,000 a month working part-time.
I'm making $5,000 a month. Never thought I'd make this much right out of school.
I actually like what I do now, and I'm making more than ever.
Put your computer to work now.
My goal for next month is $20,000.
Working from home changed my life. This is the one website you have to visit.
I love working from home.
Ready for more money? Start earning extra money yourself by going to this website today.
Log on to 7getahead.com now. Right now, as members of Best Western Speed Rewards, stay six nights and earn a free night and earn points towards exclusive NASCAR licensed merchandise. Join today at bestwesternracing.com/free night.
You know, ever since Stag Chili, the chili chili lovers love, became the official chili of Madison Square Garden, it's really taken off. Stag Chili, the official chili of Madison Square Garden.
Every day, people save more and more money on Priceline. Save when you find your own hotel. Save even more when we find it for you. Priceline now has more ways to save than any leading travel site. Priceline, more ways to save. Here's another way. Hotels up to half off. Book top hotels this spring and save up to 50% off Expedia and Hotels.com. Only on Priceline.
Program media guide here. Program,
please welcome your New York Knicks.
Want to take a half-court shot at the Garden for $100,000? Just send a non-winning New York State Lottery ticket to this address. Then watch the Knicks Magic game on MSG March 22nd. If your name comes up, you win two tickets to an upcoming Knicks game. The first winner to call the MSG hotline also wins a luxury suite to a Knicks game and qualifies you for the grand prize. A half-court shot for $100,000. Go to 1050ESPNRadio.com or NYKnicks.com for more information.
Welcome back to our St. Patrick's Day special. From New York City, there is the Chrysler Building. No, we're not in that building. We're over at the theater at Madison Square Garden. And we are ready for our next bout tonight. These are super middleweights. Let's get the call from Joe Antonacci.
Boxing fans, this next bout is scheduled for four rounds of action in the super middleweight division. Our judges overseeing this bout are John McKay, Frank Lombardi, and Matt Ruggiero. And our referee for this bout will be Benji Estevez. Introducing first in the blue corner, he comes to us tonight from Fajardo, Puerto Rico. He weighed in at 163 pounds. Black trunks, professional record, 3 victories, 5 defeats, 2 knockouts. Please welcome Willie Cruise Control. And his opponent fighting out of the red corner. He comes to us tonight from New York, New York. He weighed in at 160 and one half pounds. Silver trunks, brown trim. Perfect professional record, 2 victories, no defeats, 2 knockouts. Please welcome Peter Kid Chocolate Quillin. Referee Benji Estevez with the instructions.
Lo voy a repetir mis instrucciones. Deme una pelea limpia a los dos. Les deseo suerte. Deme un toque.
Well, I couldn't have said it better. That's Benji Estevez, the third man in the ring, ready to get this one started. These are super middleweights scheduled for four rounds. They should heat it up quickly. There's a look at Willie Cruz, 3-5 with 2 KOs. And he is ready to go, staring across the ring at Peter Quillin. Kid Chocolate, Quillin, 2-0 with 2 KOs. Says in the ring, I'm a boxer puncher. Says his best punch, he says the left hook to the body. He's naturally right-handed, but he has more power in that left hook. Will that benefit him, Mickey?
I think it will benefit him fighting a righty.
Or he's doing
a righty, you go to the body.
Already stunned in this first round. Down to the canvas, almost knocked out Willie Cruz. A good right cross, and Willie Cruz visits the canvas. Estevez giving him the mandatory 8 count, lets him go back. Cruz better keep his hands up.
If Kid Chocolate can punch, he has to keep his hands up at all times.
He punches like he has chocolate in his hands.
And he's got granite in his hands.
That's nothing to take for granted. Again, stunned. Here's Cruz. That right hand. On the attack. Cruz better keep his hands high. Estevez better stay close.
Cruz keeps his hands up high. That's when Kid Chalkers go right down to the body with that left hook.
Oh, yeah, look at Cruz moving, too, wisely. He's been hit, knocked down this round, already stunned twice. Still early in this fight. Get on his bicycle. You got to let this fight mature a little bit. All of his wins by KO for Quillin. He's got the power. Trying to set up that right hand. Can Cruz withstand this? Good assault.
Cruz has to use his leg, use his jab.
Already being punching this. Yeah, he's standing right there. He has to keep his hands moving, right?
Right, he has to use that jab and get out of that corner.
Get the jab pumping. Good left hook from Cruz. You know, somebody like Quillin, he's going to be all over you. Just put your hands out. He's coming. Good right hand from Cruz. Cruz stunned Quillin momentarily.
Well, Sean, they say to beat a good body puncher is to hit him with a body punch, so maybe Cruz should try that.
Well, this is just what Cruz needed. He needed a little cruising time. He needed to get his wits about him. Take some deep breaths. Move around a little bit. Shake out those cobwebs. Where he can shake off those punches.
Right now, I think he'll be a little bit more immune to them. His body's a little bit used to it now.
Yeah, but look at this assault. Big shots. No easy punches from Quillin.
Quillin's heavy-handed. Both hands are heavy.
Oh, yeah, former New York City Golden Gloves champion. He was 13-2 in the amateurs, was Quillin. Started boxing at 16. Mom wanted him to go to the gym, and he did. He did his homework. Good first round for him. Trying to shake out the cobwebs. He'll need this minute. Break for Willie Cruz. There's a look into his corner, Antonio. Nobody Otero over there, Mike Rella. They got a lot of work to do.
Right, they should put some water on his head, please.
Oh, yeah. Try to shake out those cobwebs. Look at these shots. Nice work from Quillin. Starts off at the body, then he works to the head. Look at these combinations. Fast, crisp, hard. They are certainly debilitating. Look at this. On the attack, Quillin. A preponderance of punches in that first round. Here's a look at the second knockdown. And it was Quillin, all boxing Peter in that first round.
He throws 4 or 5, that's when he catches
him. Round two, scheduled for 4. Round two, coming up.
Second round action. This one really heated up in that first round. Look at the punches that Quillin threw. Peter just on the attack the whole round. It was Cruz that was hurt, a couple of times knocked down, and trying to pick it up where he left it off through that.
I think this fight won't make it through this round, Sean.
Well, Cruz may still be wheezy from that knockdown in the first round, those two knockdowns. You know, he was getting tagged a lot in that first round.
Right, Cruz just seems so much stronger.
Strong, heavy punches. Cruz, you know, sometimes there's no place to run. If you're Cruz, get your hands moving. Start throwing punches right now. Try to fight back.
That's right, John. A good offense is a good defense is a good offense.
Oh, yeah. It's over. It's over. Benji Estevez read the writing on the wall. And this one goes down as a second round knockout. Peter Quillin a little bit from Willie Cruz that he didn't want to stop the fight, but Cruz was just taking too many punches. You know, in the first round, he was hurt by this man, Quillin. In the second round, he started off second being hurt. Peter Quillin, good-looking young prospect, 13-2 as an amateur, bringing that experience into the professional ranks with him. Look at this aggression. Look at the focus from Peter Quillin. Just too many punches from him that landed on Cruz. And Cruz taking those shots, just trying to do what he can to get out of the way of him. No offense from Cruz, and his defense was suspect too. There's a big smile from Peter Quillin. He gets the victory and goes to 3-0 with 3 KOs. Let's get the call now from Joe Antonacci.
Boxing fans, the time, 49 seconds of the second round. Referee Benji Estevez stops the contest. Your winner by technical knockout, now 3-0, Peter Kid Chocolate Quillin.
Well, he gets the knockout, 49 seconds of the second round, and Peter Quillin can now go and enjoy himself some chocolate. The fight's over.
Yeah, he doesn't have to make weight no more.
Kid Chocolate, and he had a really good showing. I like the aggression from him. You know, he's very aggressive. I would like to see, as this fight went on, how it changed. Let's go up to Tony Page to see what he's got to say.
Thanks very much, son. Peter, you punch like a light heavyweight. Where do you get this power from?
Cuba, man. For all the pain and stuff I've been through, that's why I punch with. Bad intention. I come to hit hard. That's what I do.
Every punch looked like a knockout shot behind
you. You got to hit with bad intention. Can't hit soft. This is not a soft game. This is a hard and heavy game, and that's what I come to do, is to fight heavy. A
couple of times he got you, but I don't think you felt the punch at all.
Nah, because, you know, I'm a hard guy. You got to hit me with a brick to put me down. That's what it is.
You're 3-0, three knockouts. What do you learn from a fight like this?
I learned everything from Colin Morgan. Put it in me to go up in here and take these guys out, or box these guys, box the ears off these guys, and that's what I'm looking to do.
When do you want to get back in the ring?
Whenever they're ready.
Next week.
Tonight, put another joker up in here with me.
I don't know if I'll be here next week, but he will be. Let's go down to ringside and Sean.
Thank you, Tony. You know, he said, talked about Colin Morgan, his trainer, giving a lot of accolades to Colin, the world-class trainer. He's trying to make a champion out of Peter Quillin. We'll see how his career develops.
Faster internet access, smarter phone service, the Optimum Double Play. Optimum Online and Optimum Voice, each just $29.95 a month for a year when you get both together. Optimum Online is 5 times faster than DSL. And Optimum Voice gives you unlimited calling in the U.S., Canada, and Puerto Rico. The Optimum Double Play, delivered to you by the most amazing fiber optic network in the nation. Save $240, only from Cablevision. Go cordless. Sign up now at Optimum.com and get this 2-handset cordless phone free. Faster internet access, smarter phone service, the Optimum Double Play. Optimum Online and Optimum Voice, each just $29.95 a month for a year when you get both together. Optimum Online is 5 times faster than DSL. And Optimum Voice gives you unlimited calling in the U.S., Canada, and Puerto Rico. The Optimum Double Play, delivered to you by the most amazing fiber optic network in the nation. Save $240, only from Cablevision. Go cordless. Sign up now at Optimum.com and get this 2-handset cordless phone free.
Welcome back to New York City and the George Washington Bridge, connecting the Big Apple with New Jersey. We're back inside the theater at Madison Square Garden, ready for super middleweights. Mean Joe Greene going up against Brian Norman. Mean Joe Greene, 8-0, 7 KOs. It was 2 years ago. Right here in this building, he had a terrific moment in the New York City Golden Gloves with that right hook knocking out his opponent. That's him in the yellow. That was 2 years ago, trying to continue that type of luck here in the theater in Madison Square Garden. He's wearing the green for Joe Greene, and he is mean in the ring tonight, going up against Brian Norman. Let's go up to our ring announcer, Joe Antonacci, to get the call.
Boxing fans, this bout is scheduled for 8 rounds of action in the super middleweight division. Our judges overseeing this bout are John McKay, Melvina Lathan, and Matt Ruggiero. And our referee for this bout will be Steve Smoger. Introducing first in the blue corner, he comes to us tonight from Decatur, Georgia. He weighed in at 167.5 pounds, wears black trunks. Professional record, 8 victories, only 3 defeats, 3 knockouts. Please welcome the assassin, Brian Norman. And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, he comes to us tonight from New York, New York. He weighed in at 162.5 pounds. green, black, and gold trunks professional record. It's perfect. 8 victories, no defeats, 7 big knockouts. Please welcome Mean Joe Greene. Referee Steve Smoger with the instructions. 6 rounds, super middleweights.
6 or 8, Joey?
Sam, 6.
6?
6.
We're going 6. All right, gentlemen. We're giving you instructions at the weigh-in. Please obey my commands, respect the bell, and above all, protect yourself at all times. Touch gloves. God bless. Thank you, Joseph, for that.
Steve Smoger, the third man in the ring, bringing out these super middleweights for a 6-rounder. It was originally, I think, scheduled for 8. They decided to cut it to 6. There's a look into Brian Norman as he prepares for Mean Joe Greene. You know, I think that's a great idea too, Mickey. If your name is Greene, you got to wear green trunks. If your name is yellow, you got to wear yellow trunks. If your name is red, that should be like a mandatory that you've got to wear the color that you are.
Right. And how fitting is it, Sean? Mean Joe Greene got all his green off of St. Paddy's Day.
Still trying to ascertain what the distance of this fight is. I think we've decided that it's 6. They were even asking you, Mickey.
Right, 6.
How many do you want to see, Mickey? How's that? Everybody's catering to Mickey Ward tonight. What
right.
a deal.
I think I get the worst eyes in the house.
Six. Well, you got a great seat.
Right, good thing.
Well, I think our seat's a little bit better than Brian Norman's and Joe Greene's seat. They're the only ones closer than us. And that is Norman on the left of your screen. Boxing's orthodox style.
Watch your little cameras, fellas.
Greene is a southpaw. Nice right jab. He says in the ring, I'm an all-around boxer. He says, my best punch, you saw it, the right hook. He is naturally right-handed, but boxes from the left-handed stance. Talking about Joe Greene on the right of your screen. Brian Norman has lost 1 in his last 5. He's coming off of a fight back in October of 2005 that he lost to Reginald Taylor.
Right, Sean, this is a good matchup for both of them. Just see what Joe Greene has and Brian Norman. 7-3, he's right there with him, so this should be a good matchup.
Good matchup, and when you face those southpaws, what are you taught to do in the gym, Mickey?
You're taught to, you're gonna move to his outside of his jab, on the other side of his jab. His left and his right hand, you wanna move on the other side of it so you're not going to his straight left.
So you're moving to your left then, as you're
right.
as you're circling around the left as you're hitting your southpaw opponent. What if you're the southpaw?
For the southpaw, I think you should keep working that jab.
Yeah, jabbing southpaw is so hard to beat. You're right. And Joe Greene uses that jab well.
They're very compact too, Sean. I think he just has to be a little bit more busier.
Yeah, a little pawing with that jab from Norman. Why do you think he's doing that?
Because he's trying to get his distance down, I think. With that pawing out that jab, he's trying to get his distance and let his punches go.
Yeah, that southpaw stance confuses you because your jab doesn't land. The reason that happens is because the right hand of your opponent, the southpaw, his hand is right in front of his face. You know, you get used to these holes, these openings in different fighters, and the southpaw stance really creates a whole new set of openings, right?
It does, and it's so hard because in the gym, you don't really have too many lefties. You're usually always sparring righties. When you get into the fight and you fight a lefty, it's just a whole different look.
Steve Smoger telling the two fighters to watch their feet. What's he talking about?
Because they're tangling feet up. The lefty always got his arm.
Take a look at how close their front feet are. Constantly, when you're fighting a southpaw, you're stepping on his toe,
right,
or he's stepping on your toe.
Exactly. You have to get your feet down just right.
And you got to be cognizant of that.
And watch yourself tripping over him.
First round action. These are super middleweights. Sean O'Grady along with Mickey Ward. Tony Page out there. Final seconds of round number 1.
Don't punch, step.
New! Get the best jokes directly on your cell phone.
They're hilarious. Write a text message with the word joke to the number 85050 and press send. They're so funny. We will make your sense of humor even better. Impress your friends. Make them laugh. Let the joke of the day be your joy of the day. Do it now. Grab your phone and text the message joke to the number 85050.
Some things you just can't copy. Like Wendy's spicy chicken sandwich. A big, juicy whole chicken breast filet. Covered with our own fiery blend of cayenne, chili peppers, and spices. For more meat and more heat. Satisfy your craving for spicy with Wendy's original spicy chicken sandwich. Don't clown around with copies. Do Wendy's. Do what tastes right.
Back at the theater in Madison Square Garden, pull up a seat. Join us ringside for a couple of super middleweights. Joe Greene with his back to you. Brian Norman now on the right. Pretty slow first round, but I think they were just trying to feel out one another. What do you think, Mickey?
Well, I think they were doing it just what you just said, feeling each other out. I think you should open up a little bit more here the second round. But they're still pouring out those jabs like you did the first round. I think why don't I go out there and set the pace?
And having the round, between round period to recuperate and to set up your fight plan. What do you think their corners are telling them?
Well, tell them to get a little more busy. You know, set the initiative. Someone's going to take the initiative in this fight. And I think whoever takes the initiative can pull the fight out, because the fight, they're very evenly matched. So whoever starts putting the pressure on one another, I think that will be the difference in the fight.
Yeah, and the combination. Would you like to see the body and head attack?
I can see the body and head attack. Well, right now, Norman's going downstairs right now. But Davis going to get up those ropes. I mean, Joe Greene has to get off the ropes.
Well, nice move from Greene. You know, the movement for a southpaw to move to his right is a lot easier than it is for him to move to his left. And Joe Greene goes that way really well. That is behind the right-handed fighter. So you got to reset every time.
Right, exactly. And what Norman should be doing is throwing that left hook over that jab.
Oh, yeah. You know, they tell us in the gym, they say, you're fighting a southpaw, you got to work on the real straight right hand, real straight, and a real wide left hook. Why does that work?
I think the left hook works as good as the right hand, because they're always looking for the right hand. If you throw the jab, feint the right hand, and throw the left hook over his jab,
Norman, it looks like they're both struggling, though, here. Does it look that way to you?
Yeah, they're not sure what either one wants to do. They're kind of like just still actually in the filling out process type of thing.
Good jab from Greene. That jab works, use it. Another good jab from Greene. Greene does a nice job of keeping his hands up around his face, his guard around his face. That comes from the amateur background that he has. So his father got him into it at 5 years old. His uncle Terrence Simpson was a pro fighter. He went 325-7 as an amateur, did Joe Greene. And now he's fighting as a professional. 8-0, 7 KOs. And there's facing you is Brian Norman, 8-3 with 3 KOs.
Greene just went straight left right down the fight. Step.
What are you setting your sights on? And when you see it, will you be ready? Just pick up the phone, dial 1-800-645-ARMY, and you'll get this free DVD. You'll learn about the hundreds of opportunities the Army can offer you. Skills, education, healthcare. Call 1-800-645-ARMY, and you'll also get this free boonie hat. Whatever you're looking for, the Army can help you find it.
Want to take a half-court shot at the Garden for $100,000? Just send a non-winning New York State Lottery ticket to this address. Then watch the Knicks Magic game on MSG March 22nd. If your name comes up, you win two tickets to an upcoming Knicks game. The first winner to call the MSG hotline also wins a luxury suite to a Knicks game and qualifies you for the grand prize. A half-court shot for $100,000. Go to 1050ESPNRadio.com or NYKnicks.com for more information.
Oh, We're back in the theater at Madison Square Garden. These are super middleweights. Joe Greene going up against Brian Norman. Not a lot happening in this fight. Look at the total punches thrown from Coffee Box.
Right, John, doing more powering than anything. They should be out there. Durbin should be out there right now, setting the pace.
Sure, and they only have 6 rounds to work with.
Exactly.
Neither guy's really done much to set a fight plan or to pull ahead on the scorecards, do you think?
No, exactly. I think they're both not doing too much right now. Someone has to land something big to get the other one going, yeah, or vice versa.
They're both posing. What do you do to get your fighter to go get him?
With all the gym work, he should be out there fighting hard every round. I mean, 2 rounds is enough to feel like. You should be out here now and let everything go.
Well, if they fought like you did, Mickey, they would. Mickey Ward, who a terrific career, now concentrating his efforts in other areas. What else are you doing, Mickey?
I'm training some fighters right now, and I'm also getting ready to run the Boston Marathon, so I'm doing a lot of running.
Boy, Boston Marathon. That's a long way.
Very long, Sean. Very long.
Well, way to go. I'm proud of you. That's good news. What should these guys be doing?
Well, neither one of them are going out and setting any kind of pace. They're both following each other around the ring, and they're not really doing much. Like right now, Green's following Norman around.
Oh, good right hand. Straight right hand. You talked about that punch down the pike, and that looked like it came right down the pike.
I think a nice left hook from Norman would be nice after the straight right hand on the pike.
You got to put the combinations together.
Right, not just one punch.
Nice right hook from Green. Green on the attack. Maybe that worked Green.
So like I said, Sean, one has to land something good to wake the other one up to start this fight going.
Well, they're asking Green to step in with the jab. You know, you got to throw combinations too. Combination punching. And both fighters really have forgotten about the body.
Right, exactly. And they're abandoning that. Now that's an important thing in 6 rounds.
Yeah, in 6 rounds, you do have enough time to set up a body attack. Good assault from Norman here. Keep your man against the ropes and punch. Your hands are free. Let him go.
And that's the thing, he's not letting him go when he's in there. He's not taking advantage of it.
Final seconds. When you hear that tapping on the mat, what should you do?
You should let it all go. When those 10 seconds, you could change the round in your favor.
Try to steal the round. Exactly right. Oh. Good right hand from Green. Green had a couple of good right hands in that round. You know, that is his favorite weapon here. Let's go back into the corner. He's got Don Turner over there, Andre Razor, Mike Rolla.
Not wait on this dude. You hear me? Don't wait for him, Pop. There's no
boxing
need to wait.
Fans, say hello to Siobhan, who is here to tell us it's time for round number 4.
We don't want him break.
Siobhan,
you the man
the
here.
Donnie Golden School five, of Irish Dance, Mineola, Long Island,
stop
and Bainbridge, Brooklyn.
Press him.
Siobhan here to tell us it's time for round number 4.
Too much respect.
You're giving him too much respect. Come on, man, let's go.
You got to press him, baby.
Come on.
Bing,
bing, bing, bing, bing, bing, bing, bing, bing, bing, bing, bing, bing, bing, bing, bing.
Andre Rozier.
The last punch on a 5-punch combination.
Right in the front. 5-punch combination, says Don Turner. The experience of Don Turner. He's worked with many great fighters, great heavyweights. Good to see him in the corner. Joe Greene and Brian Norman. Hopefully going to pick up the pace this round. You know, they were kind of pleading with Joe Greene between rounds. You have to take the initiative. There's a look at the total punch count from Coffee Box. Take the initiative. Go after him. Go get him. Let those hands fly. They said he's getting brave. He's not expecting you to press him.
Right. And they were trying to get him pumped up in the corner by telling him, stop back. Don't back up. Don't back up. 4 more punches. Keep him busy. Get him busy.
Do not wait. They said, do not wait. Good instructions.
Hands are loose. Your hands are loose.
You know, you just want, as a young fighter, you just want to make that spectacular one-punch knockout. And I can see both fighters really struggling to hit hard. They want to punch hard. Right. And they're a little bit hesitant because they don't want to get hit, and they realize the importance of a fight like this in Madison Square Garden. So they're a little bit hesitant, but you got to throw that caution to the wind and go in there and take the initiative.
Right, you have to do that. You can't wait. The longer they wait, like almost like they don't want to get hit when they're throwing. You got to take that chance, like you said, throw caution to the wind, let your hands go.
And a lot of times, maybe you take a little bit of steam off the punch so that you can just land it, make it faster, quicker. Then you get the big heavy punches in there.
Right, so three or two light, and fourth one is a heavy one.
Make them fast. Get them landing. Get your opponent used to getting hit, and then you knock him out.
Step. See, Sean, speed generates power. They should be throwing a lot of speed, and then last one, the power.
Well, we may send you over to the corners here in a little bit, Maggie, to give them that advice. That's right. There's a little bit of work. Referee Steve Smoker asking for some work. Well, they're trying a little bit more this round, trying to change it up, trying to throw more punches.
Step. Hands up, guys, hands up.
Right, you see Norman throwing that looping right hand, and he's just coming up short on it.
You know, you see those fighters too, Mickey, that struggle to throw punches like these two are. And boxing is supposed to be fluid. It's supposed to be relaxed. They're tight when they're not delivering the punch. The punch has to be compact when it connects with your opponent.
Right.
They're using a lot of the energy of the punch back at their ready position.
Right, because they're so tense and they want to hurt you so bad. Right. Yeah. They have to let it go and just relax.
Isn't it great? Hands up. Final seconds, round number four. They a little bit better this round. They are certainly heating it up.
Keep your elbow in.
The best coach I ever had was my dad.
Practice.
He taught me that the fundamentals, together with hard work, make anything possible. And now it's time to teach others what my dad taught me.
Introducing Steve Nash's MVP Basketball, the only instructional DVD program that makes superstar Steve Nash your personal coach. You'll learn Steve's fundamental training secrets to give you a competitive edge on the court.
I don't think there's anybody in the NBA that does it any better than Steve Nash.
What an opportunity to have Steve Nash as your child's personal coach.
This program is about the fundamentals of basketball. And Steve Nash knows the fundamentals of basketball.
Call or go online now to order Steve Nash's MVP Basketball program for the low introductory price of only $29.95. Act now and you'll receive a second DVD, Steve's Team Play and Practice Organization, perfect for the parent coach, absolutely free. But it's not available in stores, so you must act now.
Is that your new Sprint phone?
Uh-huh. With Sprint's new fair and flexible plans, no one can tell me what to do. I can talk when and how I want. It's my little way of sticking it to the man.
But you are the man.
I know.
So you're sticking it to yourself.
Maybe.
Sprint's new fair and flexible plans. With no huge overages or roaming charges, you control your plan. It doesn't control you. Plans start at just $29.99 a month. Sprint, yes you can.
Here at Sympathetic Car Rental, we offer low, low rates.
Excuse me. I've been in this line forever, and where are my member savings?
Somebody needs a hug. Who do you think we are? Hertz?
Hertz Number One Club offers special savings, gets you to your vacation faster, and lets you reserve a specific brand and model. Sign up free at Hertz.com.
Well, they are ready for round number five. A lot of instructions between rounds from both corners. Mickey, what did you hear?
I heard good instructions. They want them to both pick it up. They want Norman to back him up and faint him. So when he faints him, when he comes back in, and to catch him as he's coming back in.
Good instruction?
I think it's a really good instruction.
You took a look at the punch stat there, and not a lot of output from these two junior middle or super middleweights. But right. They did pick it up a bit in that last round, and hopefully they just continue that here.
Right. They picked it up a lot the last round, Sean. Hopefully they bring it back and bring it up to this round.
There it is. A little bit of yelling from his punches when he's throwing punches. Brian Norman yelling. Why is he doing that?
I think it's the way he's breathing. I think that's the way he breathes when he punches. They're both kind of doing the same thing.
Hands up, hands up.
They're throwing very hard punches, but they're just missing each other.
And that's why between rounds they were telling them both to feint. Feint in there and then throw your punch. You want to feint your opponent out of position and then hit him.
Right, to feint them to see how he reacts to it. And then the next time feint him again and you can count him off that reaction.
See how he reacts. Kind of a probing shot out there. Also, this yelling that they're doing when they're punching, kind of a psychological advantage. You kind of scare your opponent. In the ring, especially if you haven't brushed your teeth in a few weeks, that works every time.
Exactly.
You hit them with bad breath. It's a new weapon some fighters have. You know, every shot from these two have knockout written all over it. When your opponent knows that you're trying to knock him out, it's harder to get him to acquiesce to this idea of you knocking him out unless he's not thinking about it.
Exactly. When you're looking for that knockout, you never get it.
Right.
Mark.
Bleeding from the corner. Boy, what a draining fight for both fighters. And you know, tomorrow they'll both be sore from this.
Oh, yeah, because there's a lot of wrestling going on too, Sean.
Yeah, not just the fighting, but the wrestling.
Right.
But a learning experience for a couple of young super middleweights. 8-3 for Norman with his back to you right there. 3 KOs, 8-0 with 7 KOs for Mean Joe Greene. There goes the mouthpiece. Norman's hurt. Mouthpiece came flying out from Brian Norman. Getting caught with the right hook. There's the mouthpiece. Good combination to accentuate the end of that round for Mean Joe Greene. There's a look into the corner.
You got lax coming out. That was the only deal. Take a deep breath. Give me a deep breath.
And here's a look at what happened. Look at Mean Joe Greene. Got Mean on the aggression. Good cross from Greene. And then he lands there with the mouthpiece. A little wobble from Norman. Mouthpiece right in front of us.
AB, you see him every time, man. You've been letting this guy miss and get away with it. When he misses, you got to be right on his ass.
Bernard Styles.
When he misses, you got to be right on his ass.
Boxing fans, put your hands together. This is the
sixth. Look at Joe Greene. He's ready for this final round.
This fight's up in the air, Sean.
Right here, right here. Here's JoJo, Joey. God right bless here. You both. Come on, Joey, turn around. Turn around, Joey.
There's a look at the comedy box numbers. 195 to 210. Thrown, look at them landed. Pretty even landed, but a slow-paced fight.
Yes.
Both of them looking for that home run ball. You know, when you're standing at the plate, Mickey, you try to hit the home run, what do?
You never hit it.
Strikeout, yes.
You never hit it.
Oh, look at these two now. Now they're picking it up. Trying to accentuate this at the end. I know this is the final round.
Green's come alive in the end of the last round and the beginning of this round. He's come alive.
Yeah, it was a slow start. Remember back in that first and second round, they both kind of parried. And they started picking it up in the third and the fourth. And here we are in the sixth with the good aggression from Greene. Norman was hurt at the end of that fifth round. How close do you think this will be? The judges have to call this one.
I think it's a very close fight. I think Greene's a little bit ahead of so far in this fight. He's going to put a lot of pressure on him.
Pressure is the key here.
Keep the pressure on because he's still hurting tight.
In the final round, you want to impress the judges, right?
Right, you want to finish off with a fast, a good, hard, strong round.
But this assault from the end of that fifth round may win this fight for Joe Greene. He's hurt again. Norman wobbled. Greene knows it.
Good right hook.
Greene coming alive. He knows it's St. Patrick's Day. He's wearing of the green. Joe Greene is Mean this final round.
This is what he should have been doing that third round.
inside the final minute.
Hands up, boy.
Joe Greene really on the attack this final round. And he's effective. Trying to hold on, trying to tie up, buying some time is Brian Norman.
Now Norman's body's wide open, Sean. Well, that's when he should go downstairs right now. Greene.
Oh, right, good uppercut. Norman has been six rounds in his last three fights, winning two of them. And Mean Joe Greene has been six rounds only one occasion. But he's setting a good pace here in this final round. Look at the attack.
He's throwing everything with bad and bad intentions.
He's mean.
He is.
Sounds like a football player, too. Final seconds and Greene sends it off. Ends it with a good combination. Joe Greene, he was mean in the final couple of rounds, but started out slowly, but he really showed us his style and his aggression late in this fight.
Right, it was a chess match at the beginning, Greene come on at the end.
Trying to set up their battle plans, both fighters. There's a look in the corner of Greene. It's all over now. He had to hustle the last couple of rounds, and here he is in that final round with the attack, that left hand doing a lot of damage. He likes the right hook, but he's got a good left hand too. Now remember, he's naturally right-handed, so he would obviously have more power in that right hook. But he throws a good left too. He's busy.
He mixes his punches up very well. When he lets his hands go.
Oh yeah, well it took him a while to get going in the early part of this fight. He kind of standing around looking and kind of getting into it. He was trying to feel out his opponent and see what Brian Norman was going to bring to this dance. There's a look at Don Turner, all smiles from him now. And a look at Andre Rozier.
I think Don likes what he's seen those last two rounds.
Okay, the last two rounds were pretty good. He's a young man on his way. There's a look at Norman and his handler, Barry Richardson. Bernard Stiles giving good instructions in between rounds. We were listening in. You know, he kept telling him, you've got to put on the pressure, you've got to use the jab, you have to out-hustle this man. And I think the final couple of rounds, Brian Norman just got out-hustled. There's a look at the total punch count from these two. You know, and look at Greene, almost twice as many punches landed from Mean Joe Greene.
It was like a horse race. Got beat down the stretch.
Exactly. Beat down the stretch. Now, I like that. Beat down the stretch, a horse race. Yep. Final couple of rounds, it was like a ball game, too.
Exactly.
Joe pitching, Norman catching.
Yep.
Good feeling right here, although you got to be thinking to yourself, where's the judges' scorecards? What are the judges thinking? Because we're still awaiting the final tally.
Here's what the undefeated is thinking. Did I do enough?
In that final round, it was Mean Joe Greene on the attack. He landed 53. I'm sorry, he landed 30 of the 53 punches he threw. So he had a busy, missing a lot of punches, but he went ahead and landed a lot as well. And I think our ring announcer has the scorecards, trying to, they got it all deciphered and totaled up. There seems to be some kind of mix up with it, so just getting a little bit of clarification on the judge's scorecard. And they are. Fine job here at the New York State Athletic Commission, making sure all the scorecards are added properly. But boy, you don't like this as a fighter, do you, Mickey?
No, you don't.
Wondering what's happening.
It's almost like, what is happening? I don't know.
Well, I think we've got it all figured out now, and let's listen to Joe Antonacci. Joe?
Boxing fans, after six rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecard. Judge Melfeet Vina Lathan scores the bout 59-54. Judge Matt Ruggiero scores it 59-55. And Judge John McKay scores the bout 58-56. All for your winner by unanimous decision, Mean Joe Greene.
Well, there it is. Mean Joe Greene gets the victory. He got mean in the final few rounds and started putting the combinations together. He realized that the pace had slowed. He looked for that optimal moment, and I think he found it. He certainly learned a lot to like. Mean Joe Greene gets the victory, and he moves on to 9-0 with 7 KOs. We'll be back.
Faster internet access, smarter phone service, the Optimum Double Play. Optimum Online and Optimum Voice, each just $29.95 a month for a year when you get both together. Optimum Online is 5 times faster than DSL. And Optimum Voice gives you unlimited calling in the U.S., Canada, and Puerto Rico. The Optimum Double Play, delivered to you by the most amazing fiber optic network in the nation. Save $240, only from Cablevision. Go cordless. Sign up now at Optimum.com and get this 2-handset cordless phone free.
Welcome back to the theater at Madison Square Garden. Crowd still buzzing. Busy 6-round fight, super middleweights. Mean Joe Greene, how appropriate, Mickey. Mean Joe Greene gets a victory. He is wearing the green, and it is St. Patrick's Day. Let's go up to the ring with Tony Page, who has Mean Joe in hand.
Thanks very much, John. Joe, a hard workout today.
Yeah. It was a pretty good fight. He was a good fighter. He came to fight tonight. I was in shape, and I took over.
Good lesson there. If you were not in shape, what happens tonight?
I mean, it could have been a different, you know, turnaround. You know what I mean? But I was in shape. God blessing me, I was in shape. Training hard every day, running every day, doing what I had to do. And I was the victor of the match.
You were throwing some heavy punches in there. Were you trying to set him up for a knockout? It just wasn't coming?
I mean, I was taking it slow, you know what I'm saying? Because I seen what kind of fighter he was. So I was just kind of taking everything slow, you know, pacing myself, and not trying to go for the knockout early in the fight. But I know there's a possibility I could have won 6 rounds tonight.
You'd like to get back in the ring real soon?
Yeah, soon as possible. I was born to do this, man.
All right, man, congratulations. We're back with more boxing after this.
Mrs. Wilson, Credit Guard of America is able to cut your monthly credit card payments by $248.
Mr. Lynch, it looks like you'll be able to save over $13,000 in interest payments with Credit Guard of America.
Credit Guard of America is a nonprofit credit counseling company.
We're here to help you solve your credit problems and meet your financial goals.
Take this important first step toward financial freedom and call Credit Guard of America. Certified credit counselors are standing by right now.
If you are $3,000 or more in debt and 30 days behind in payments, we can help you. So call our toll-free number.
Our certified credit counselors are standing by to provide you with free credit counseling services and assist you in becoming debt-free.
Take this important first step toward financial freedom right now and call Credit Guard of America. Certified credit counselors are standing by right now. Call Credit Guard of America.
We can assist you in becoming debt-free.
Welcome back to the world's most famous arena, Madison Square Garden in New York, for our special St. Patrick's Day fight night. Inside the theater at Madison Square Garden, we are just about ready to go for some female fighting. 4-rounder, and these are lightweights. And female fighting has become so exciting, Mickey. Because, first of all, they're only 2-minute rounds, and the girls don't know how to back up. They are very aggressive in the ring. They make for terrific matches. And coming in with the color guard is Maureen Shea. In there somewhere, 4-0, the undefeated prospect. Maureen Shea, does that name sound familiar? You may know her from her work with Hillary Shank. She worked with Hilary Swank and the Clint Eastwood movie produced Million Dollar Baby. She may fight a little bit like Hilary Swank.
Non-stop, Swank.
There you go.
Non-stop.
And she is ready to go. So is her opponent tonight, taking on Leanne Villarreal from Albuquerque, New Mexico. Let's get the introduction. We'll go up to our ring announcer, Joe Antonacci.
Boxing fans, our next bout is scheduled for four rounds of action in the women's lightweight division. Our judges overseeing this bout are John McKay, Frank Lombardi, and Matt Ruggiero. And our referee for this bout will be Benji Esteves. Introducing first in the blue corner, she comes to us tonight from Albuquerque, New Mexico. She weighed in at 131 pounds and wears blue trunks with white trim. Tonight, she is appearing in her eighth professional bout. Please welcome Vicious Leanne Villarreal. And her opponent fighting out of the red corner. She comes to us tonight from the Bronx in New York City. She also weighed in at 131 pounds, wears Kelly Greene trunks, and sports a perfect professional record of 4 victories, no defeats, 3 big knockouts. Please welcome Maureen, the Kerry Kid Shea. Benji Esteves with the instructions.
And take that top off. Okay, ladies, you'll be giving your instructions again. Protect yourself at all times. Obey my commands at all times. Touch them up. Good luck to both of you.
Benji Esteves, this one's scheduled for four rounds. And they are ready to go. There's a look at Maureen Shea. Undefeated. 4 fights, 3 by KO. And Leanne Villarreal.
Looks like they want to go at it, Sean.
Well, I don't suspect we'll see much dancing in this one.
I don't
think so. High-paced, a high-action fight. The rounds are only 2 minutes, so they really go after. You know, I go do these fights all over the country, and the female boxing end of it seems to be stealing a lot of the cards and a lot of the crowd because of their aggression. It seems, too, that the female fighters are all about the same level. Would you agree with that, Mickey?
For the most part, yeah, I think they are.
Yeah.
I think almost pretty much all of them are. There's a few that isn't, but for the most part, they are, and they're very exciting fights, like you said. People like watching because it's exciting.
Good combination from Maureen. She throws good uppercuts, crosses, jabs, and she's busy. Oh, Villarreal got hit with a big left hook. Maureen on the attack. Villarreal fighting back. Villarreal should get her head up. She's covering her head down too much.
Right, exactly.
Take your head off your opponent. You keep your eyes on the ground. You can't see your target.
Right, that's what she's doing, putting her head down. I mean, she'll be covering the uppercuts when she does that. Rip those uppercuts up there.
Looks like Maureen's wearing a headgear with their with their hair in the braids like that. It's
right.
Pretty cool. That would keep your hair from flopping around, I guess, getting in your face. Look at the hair of, in contrast, look at the hair of Leanne.
Right. It's going to go in her eyes any second now.
There is Shea with the foot feint over there. She is on the right. Her trainer is Hector Rocha, who has become a terrific professional trainer in male boxing. Got Maureen Shea. Maureen Shea, busy first round for her. Villarreal has to get her head up and get busy in this fight. Throw punches.
Want to take a half-court shot at the Garden for $100,000? Just send a non-winning New York State Lottery ticket to this address. Then watch the Knicks Magic game on MSG March 22nd. If your name comes up, you win 2 tickets to an upcoming Knicks game. The first winner to call the MSG hotline also wins a luxury suite to a Knicks game and qualifies you for the grand prize. A half-court shot for $100,000. Go to 1050ESPNRadio.com or NYKnicks.com for more information.
New! Get the best jokes directly on your cell phone. They're hilarious! Write a text message with the word joke to the number 85050 and press send. They're so funny. We will make your sense of humor even better. Impress your friends. Make them laugh. Let the joke of the day be your joy of the day. Do it now. Grab your phone and text the message joke to the number 85050.
Well, a busy first round, and they pick it up where they left off in that first. It was Shea on the attack in that first round. Shea in the green, and Villarreal on the in the blue. You know, they told Villarreal between rounds, you got to start throwing punches. You got to be busy. And there's a look at it. Look at the landed shots.
Right, she landed 11 to 2. She only threw 18. Yeah. She has to get more busy in order to win this fight, without a doubt.
Well, if you throw the right punch, you just need one.
Well, right.
If you're a power hitter. But Villarreal swinging wildly. Going to the outside. The shortest distance between 2 points is a straight line. Shea's punches inside.
Right, he's going inside the wide punches.
How about Villarreal's hands down by her waist? Is that...
They're down by her waist, and she's looking down at the ground when she throws a punch. I think Maureen Shea should time that and rip an uppercut. Step in there and rip that uppercut up.
Maureen Shea showing us a little bit of turning and pivoting and some of her skills in the ring. For Villarreal, putting her head down and her hands up like that may be protection, but it sure gives a horrible impression to the judges.
Right. It's almost like a sparring partner syndrome. She has just taking the punches and just getting the work in.
That was a good right hand from Leanne. Boy, a lot of movement. Look at this movement from Shea.
Shea got good movement, but she should be letting her hands go more.
Well, she does a nice job of not crossing her feet. Difficult thing for fighters to do, not to cross their feet.
Right.
Oh, they heated up at the end, and a big look from Maureen Shea. Busy second round. And why don't we go across the way to Tony Page, who has a very special guest. Tony?
Thanks very much, John. I'm here with Maureen Shea's father, John, and happy birthday, by the way.
Thank you very much.
How's your daughter look so far?
Pretty good. She's she stays focused. She'll look good.
Did she promise you a win for your birthday?
No, she didn't.
Why not?
No, I don't put no pressure. We don't put no pressure on her. She doesn't know her opponent, and she just goes in and does her best. She stays focused.
Are you nervous?
Yes. Yeah.
You just want it to be over?
No, it's her fight to fight, but like I say, she'll do all right. She looks good.
And you encourage her to do this?
No, not at all. This is her own choice in life.
Thanks very much, John. Happy birthday. Sean, back to you.
Oh, that's perfect, Tony. Sweating bullets over there is dad, you know, your birthday and St. Patrick's Day, and your daughter's out there boxing. And he's got to be sitting on needles and pins over there.
Right, he doesn't want to see his baby get hurt.
Well, she's doing pretty well.
She is doing very well.
A lot of movement from her, some good punches, some maneuvering.
I think when she goes down to the body, Sean, that's going to be the key for her.
Real effective and more pressure this round. Look at her. The strength. She's trying to back up Leanne Villarreal.
His left hooks to the body are doing it right now.
Come on, says Leanne. And Maureen obliges. Good right hand from Maureen. Another good right hand from Shea.
The left hook to the body is tremendous right now.
Well, Shea is on the attack. She's looking for the knockout this round. She wants it. Look at these combinations. Downstairs to the body is Shea.
Nice. Nice body pull. Nice body work.
She knows it too. Damage to the body.
Also, that uppercut's wide open now. She didn't hit the body. Go to the body, then come right back up to the middle.
Look the body in there. Hear those punches. Oh, they sound like they hurt. And they do.
They do it. They do it right.
Hurts to get hit in the body. Doesn't hurt. There's no pain getting hit in the head. You hurt to get hit in the body. It hurts.
Yes.
You hit in the head, you just go to sleep.
That's it.
No pain to it.
And shake the head off, or you can't shake the body off.
Boy, certainly look at a different complexion this round from Shea than you did in the last round. A lot of punches from her, busy style. Maureen Shea was looking for the knockout here in this third round.
Yeah, that was an excellent round.
Crowd appreciates it.
Muy bien, pero no te quedes enfrente. Está pegando y te quedas enfrente. Cambia los pies, cambia. Cambia, no te quedes enfrente. Para que tú puedas meter un golpe bien, tienes que cambiar los pies.
That is Maureen Shea. She's fluent in Spanish. Her mother is Mexican descent.
Mano arriba.
Okay. And that is Hector Lioka over there.
Pero con I was going to say that, John. She's taught in Spanish to him.
Yeah. Yeah, no a lo bruto.
Hello, Mom. Proud mom. I wonder if she's as nervous as Dad.
I think so.
Mom and Dad both looking for a big birthday present and a St. Patrick's Day present. There they are, Mom, Dad.
Put your hands together. This is the fourth and final round.
Fourth and final round. Somebody forgot the mouthpiece, and they're getting that put in from Villarreal. Just a whoops. Forgot my mouthpiece. I think they should maybe tie a string around it.
Well, I think Leanne could use it. Leanne could use the rest.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. She could use it. Maureen ready to go in that last round. Maureen threw 95 punches in only 2 minutes. Remember the female boxing in 2 minute rounds.
Watch it out.
That in the third round. Well, it dropped again. She's buying a little bit more time.
Let's go.
Leanne.
Okay, that's all right, that's all right.
She's trying to hang in there. Boy, a lot of bruises around her face. She is taking quite a few wallops.
Leanne's taking a lot of punches. She's a game girl. She's very game, but she's taking a lot.
Oh, look at that. Both of them firing. Leanne just keeping her head down and throwing wildly. Maureen Shea just looking for her marks.
She's in there trying to throw the home run ball. Hit the home run ball.
Yeah, look at that. Maureen does a nice job of keeping her eyes on your target. See your target and then hit it.
Right.
For Leanne, she's got her head down. She's kind of swinging wildly. Now, she lands occasionally, but she doesn't really plan it, you know?
Right, she just wings it. Wings it wildly. She is. She yeah. Isn't looking where it's going.
Plan it and plant it. Right?
Exactly.
Busy. Look how busy these two. Female boxers are. They're tough.
They're tough. Throwing a lot of punches, too. You got to give it to them, Sean. Throwing a lot of punches.
Shea really doing a fine job the last couple of rounds on the body. Remember that third round? She was downstairs. A lot of thudding shots to the midsection.
And it slowed Leanne down a lot. Slow her down, real life. That body work.
Way behind on the scorecards, I would have to think, is Villarreal.
Yes, but one thing, she's still in the game trying.
She's tough.
She's tough. She's in there trying.
You know, it's a hard deal. It's a hard thing when you got to stay in that ring like that. She's hanging in there.
She's hanging in there. There's nowhere to go, and she's still trying. But Maureen Shea just a couple steps above.
And Shea finishes off strongly. Maureen Shea. Leanne Villarreal. Dad, I guess, is happy. I think, Maureen more animated than Dad. Yeah, big smile from her.
Right.
Dad still, I guess he's thinking about the decision. Although I got Maureen, I did fine.
And still plenty of energy.
Oh, yeah. She's in good shape. I'll tell you, Hector Rocha gets people in the gym, and he really works them out. He's solid professional trainer.
Well, you can see that. She went a good four hard rounds. A lot of punches thrown for just 2 minutes.
just a little bit of, this is a great time. A little posing, you get the works all over. You
boxing fans will
enjoy the crowd.
For the judges' scorecards. One more time, I want to introduce a gentleman here at ringside. He is a three-time world champ, lightweight, welterweight, and junior middleweight champ. Say hello to Sugar Shane Mosley right here. That's a champion right there.
Sugar Shane Mosley, look at that. Former welterweight, super welterweight champion. And he just won a big fight.
In the middle of it.
Yeah, and he just won a big fight over
Fernando Vargas.
Fernando, yeah.
Great fighter.
Boxing fans, after four rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all three judges, Matt Ruggiero, Frank Lombardi, and John McKay, all see the bout 40-36. All in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the Bronx in New York City, by the way of Kerry, Ireland, Maureen, the Kerry Kid, Shea.
Well, thank you, Joe Antonacci. The Kerry Kid. She gets the victory. Parents are happy. She celebrates St. Patrick's Day. Maureen Shea smiling for the judges and for the cameras, and they love her. Spunky performance from Maureen Shea. We'll be back with more boxing.
For the free all-access pre-show playing March 23rd through April 17th. Get your tickets today.
Lord, just grant me this one prayer. If we could just beat the Flyers and the Devils and the Isles and Buffalo and Ottawa. If we could just beat those guys, I will never ask for another thing except to make the playoffs. Oh, and to win a Stanley Cup again in my lifetime. And please keep your army healthy. I will never ask for another thing ever again, ever, until next season.
Are you still being charged too much for internet service? Still waiting for a better deal? Well, your wait is over. With People PC Online, you get unlimited internet access for just $10.95 a month. And you get accelerator technology free for an entire year. That's a $60 value. Visit up to 5 web pages in the time it used to take to visit one, and pay just $10.95 a month. Plus, our smart dialer automatically chooses the fastest, most reliable access number. Want more? You even get security tools to help protect you from spam, pop-ups, and email viruses. Compare us side-by-side with your current ISP. Go to peoplepc.com to try us free for 30 days. Surf up to 5 times faster for an entire year with free accelerator technology. All this for just $10.95 a month. But hurry, this special offer is for a limited time only. Go online or call 1-800-748-9296. People PC Online with free accelerator, a better way to internet.
Welcome back to the theater at Madison Square Garden. You just saw Maureen Shea with a victory over Leanne Villarreal. Let's go up to Tony Page and hear what Maureen's got to say. Tony?
Thanks very much, Sean. So Maureen, nice little workout today.
Yeah, it was great. It was really good. Tough girl came out to fight. That's what I want. I want them all to come out and fight.
Were you focused because your parents were here?
Oh, definitely. Yeah. Once I leave that locker room, I don't even look at the audience. I don't look at anything. All I see is the ring. I look at Hector, and we go. We do what we got to do. Now I'm noticing how many people are here, and now I'm like, well, okay.
I asked your father, did you get him something for his birthday? He said no.
I didn't even say happy birthday to him because I put it on my skirt, and I wanted to wait till he saw it on my skirt.
How's your mom and your father react? Because I asked your father, is this your idea? He said no.
No, it wasn't. I actually hid it from them for like 6 months before I first started training. But now they're just, hey, I'm going to do it. I was always wanting to do what I wanted. My dad always said, you march to your own drummer. So here I am marching, and I feel like I'm doing it pretty well. I got a lot of good people in my corner, Hector Roca, Luigi Alcese, Aaron Platz, Martin Gonzalez, and I'm doing it, and I'm happy.
You fight as fast as you talk.
Oh, I have to slow down. That's right. They're going to yell at me for this. I'm sorry.
Well, what's you learn in this type of a fight tonight?
I learned that I need to be a little bit quicker. I am a little bit quicker. I tend to throw punches, like, you know, with bad intentions, but all the punches can be with bad intentions, but I got to pop a little more speed behind there. So this is a good experience. I used more movement in this fight than I did my last one, as far as upper head movement and stuff and playing a little bit more. So it was good. It's what we wanted to do. We did it.
She fights like a champ. She talks like a champ. We'll be back with more boxing. Come on back.
Have you ever heard the saying, there's power in numbers? Did you know there's a three-digit number so powerful it can cost you or save you thousands of dollars? It's your credit score. That's why it's so important to stay on top of your credit at FreeCreditReport.com. Log on to FreeCreditReport.com and find out how you can get your free credit report and credit score instantly and online. Log on to FreeCreditReport.com.
Free credit report offer applies with enrollment and Triple Advantage.
Hey, presenting man. MSG's Jimmy Cavallo.
Oh, yeah. That's good. My man, my man. Oh! All right. Here we go. Right here, 2-on-2 for a case of Snapple. You can pick anyone. Anyone?
Time to go to school, dog.
Catch the Snapple High School basketball game of the week, Sunday at 9 on MSG.
Clyde, you can still dish it.
And swish it.
Some things you just can't copy. Like Wendy's spicy chicken sandwich. A big, juicy, whole chicken breast filet. Covered with our own fiery blend of cayenne, chili peppers, and spices. For more meat and more heat. Satisfy your craving for spicy with Wendy's original spicy chicken sandwich. Don't clown around with copies. Do Wendy's. Do what tastes right.
Foxwoods Resort Casino, a special stop on the World Poker Tour, the Foxwoods Poker Classic. Visit foxwoods.com for satellite and tournament information.
Welcome back to New York City. That building looks familiar. Empire State Building, and hey, there's a place. Let's make a reservation now, Mickey. That place will be packed tomorrow.
Exactly.
Everybody there enjoying the festivities of St. Patrick's Day, and welcome to this very special St. Patrick's Day fight from Madison Square Garden. We're in the theater, and I think we're just about ready for the next fight. To get the announcements, let's go up to Joe Antonucci.
Boxing fans, our next bout is featured for 6 rounds of action in the middleweight division. Our judges overseeing this bout are Melvina Latham, Frank Lombardi, and John McKay. And our referee for this bout will be Steve Smoger. Introducing first in the blue corner, he comes to us tonight all the way from Savannah, Georgia. He weighed in at 154 pounds. Black trunks, gold trim. Fine professional record, 10 victories, only 2 defeats. Please welcome Jose Felix. And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, he comes to us tonight from Arklow, Ireland. He weighed in at 157 pounds. White trunks, green trim. Perfect professional record, 4 victories, no defeats, 3 big knockouts. Please welcome James Moore.
Center ring.
All right, gentlemen, you're giving your instructions at the weigh-in. Please obey my commands. Respect the bell, and above all, protect yourself at all times. Touch gloves? Touch. God bless.
6 rounds.
Well, he's 4-0 with 3 KOs. James Moore, the stablemate to John Duddy. This is a 165 Open champion from the 2004 New York City Golden Gloves. And he looks across the ring at Jose Felix from Savannah, Georgia.
I've seen Will fight, Sean. He can fight. This kid can fight. Should be a real good fight here.
Good fighter, and he wisely starts off with a left jab. Good to see that, and that comes from the amateur background. This James Moore, with his back to you, says that he went to the gym with his dad. His dad was a trainer, and he went to the gym, and he wanted to learn to box. He started boxing at six. There's a good right hand. Moore punches. He said he had over 300 amateur fights, and we heard Tony talking about that. And bronze medalist in the World Games of 2001. He's been a busy kid.
He can fight really good. He, like you said, busy amateur. He's bringing that experience into the pros room, and he looks good so far. Great so far.
I think he knows his way around the ring. You can see that here. Good balance from him and good pressure. And I tell you, Jose Felix is trying to fight back. Felix from Savannah, Georgia. Mike Gerald, his manager and trainer.
Punch. Very good. Felix with 11 fights. It's good experience for Moore, anyway, with a guy with 11 fights.
Oh, yeah. And a guy in Felix who has been busy in his 11 fights. You know, I know Felix because my son is actually a trainer in the gym that he works out in Savannah. Mike Gerald's got a terrific gym over there, so I feel like Felix is going to come into this fight in shape. But getting outpunched in this first round by Moore.
Yeah, a lot of pressure by Moore. He wants to take the fight right out of Felix fast.
Well, he starts the attack. Look at that. Nice work from him. Downstairs to the body, up to the head. Covering up is Jose Felix.
You see him in there, Sean. He dug a left hook to the body and Felix's left leg went.
That hurts. Look at that jab, too. Watch it start off with a jab. Does Moore. He's jabbing, jabs his way in, and then he throws the right cross. That's good schooling. Schooling. Good schooling.
That's it. Good amateur background. We'll do that.
Well, Felix has got to be wondering if he's in a leather blizzard.
Right, exactly.
A lot of punches.
This kid punches in bunches. That's what he should be doing.
Exactly. And Moore is on top of him. He's a lot of pressure. Good combination from Moore. More punches.
Not giving him in a second to breathe.
Felix really flustered in his first round. He needs to dig into his bag of tricks.
He has to pull something out.
Straight to the body, you know what I'm saying? Keep that pressure on. Now he's running. Fake him out.
Fake him out. Looking for pressure from Moore. The body shots accumulate. Good work downstairs, and they also lower your opponent's guard so you can hit him in the head.
Right, exactly. Go downstairs and finish upstairs.
Moore just, yeah, I love this style. Get in there and fight, and he's really, really carrying the action. James Moore ready to go for the second round.
So good to see a young fighter come out like that and just let it all go. Put on a good show.
Boy, look at that aggression. Jabbing, this is an offensive jab, moving in like that. Look at the combo box scores, too. I mean, no question, we knew the answer to that. But
right.
Felix getting in a few punches here and there, which is not the force that Moore has.
I mean, he's trying, but he's fighting a little spark plug here.
Look at that. Wow, good combination. Moore's in good shape.
Punch. Man hands are loose.
Jose Felix got into boxing at 11 years old in Albuquerque. Fought with Danny Romero and Johnny Tapia. He said he had about 20 amateur fights before turning pro back in 2003. So he knows his way around the ring. And
good right hand by Moore. Very good right hand. Going to follow it up with a left hook.
Body shots. Already breathing heavily is Jose Felix. Felix knew nothing about Moore. Moore, debilitating body punch.
That body punch is taking its toll on him.
Felix looking for a break.
I don't think Moore's gonna agree with that. I think he just wants to keep going. No breaks.
Reminds me so much of the pocket rocket, Wayne McCullough, the way he fought. Just a lot of pressure, you know, a lot of punches on top of his opponent.
Right, exactly. A lot of pressure. Just take the heart out of your opponent.
Good shit. Now, that's the way you fought, Mickey.
Yeah, that's how I tried to fight.
Pressure. Down to the canvas from the body shot, the left hook to the liver. Six. Felix has to be wondering what's happening.
How's your body?
Good. How do you feel? Great.
I don't think he can recover from something like this. Yeah.
Moore knows it too. You sense it. You put your opponent down on the canvas once. You can do it twice and three times.
Right, exactly. He is ripping those body punches. I think Steve's going to stop it.
He's been where he's going. Jose Felix.
Six, seven, eight. One more knockdown, you're out of here.
A little blood on the nose, the bridge of the nose.
Walk over here.
From Jose Felix. Final seconds, will he make it through the second round? He did, busy pace. And James Moore kept on the pressure in that second round.
Look at
your ribs hurt?
No.
You're right. One more round.
Left glove.
Jose, lift your left leg.
You want to continue?
A little testing on the corner. The doctor visiting the corner. Here is the second knockdown. That left hook to the body, right on the liver. And down to the canvas goes Felix. Tried to get up. He's trying to fight back, but he's just being overwhelmed with these punches. Look at that. Five right hands in a row.
Unanswered, too.
Unanswered. And you know what? Jose Felix just doesn't know what to do. He's in there with a buzzsaw. Look at these punches coming, you know, from every angle. How do you defend against that?
Just gonna let your hand. It's hard for me to say, but you just have to get in there and just kind of let your hands go. It's the only chance he has.
Exactly. He's gonna go down swinging. If you're gonna go down swinging. All right, look at the difference there and the numbers from CompuBox. All the punches being thrown by Moore. And look at this attack. Look at this pressure. That makes fighters fold. And it is over. Steve Smoger waves it off. That's all. James Moore gets the victory and the crowd loves it.
Asking action on the St. Patty's Day.
He loves it. He loves it too. And you know what? He gave the fans a show. Jose Felix tried, but just outpunched, outskilled. That's exciting, a great feeling. The fight's over, you win, and your music is playing. And it's St. Patrick's Day.
Right.
What more
nothing
can you
like
ask
it.
For?
Nothing like it, Sean.
That's great. The crowd loves it. From County Wicklow, Ireland, just south of Dublin, that's James Moore. Downstairs to the body, and this fight is over.
Left hook downstairs, and that was it.
halftime. The writing was on the wall. James Moore, a big smile from him as Moore runs his record to 5-0 with 4 KOs. Let's get the call of this fight from Joe Antonacci.
We love the jungle team. That's where the lions sing.
Boxing fans.
James Moore, he's got his Irish fans smiling. And we'll be back with more boxing, maybe a little visit from Tony Page with James Moore. We'll be back in New York City after this message. Stay with us, we got more boxing to come. City at the theater in Madison Square Garden. The crowd's still buzzing over that knockout of James Moore. And Mickey, here it is. It was Moore on the attack all night. What pressure.
Right, for a young guy, for a young fighter like Moore, to set his man up again, finish off down to the boy, that's unbelievable.
He's a wise fighter for only 5 fights now. Young kid's got a lot of skills. How about that, Tony Page?
Thanks very much. Where did you get the energy from? Was it this crowd?
Oh, the crowd is great, yeah. Definitely, it's like, you know, it's an extra couple of rounds, but I've been training since the 2nd of January for this fight, you know. I killed myself in the gym. You know, I'm just in great shape, you know. I'm ready to go again. I'll be going again now in a couple of weeks, hopefully, so.
You have less than 10 fights, but your body attack looks like a veteran of 40 fights. How do you do that so well?
Well, all through the amateurs, you know, amateur boxing is so much headhunting. I figured, why not go for the body? So all my amateur fights, I was working the body, and definitely that's where it comes from, and you know.
What would happen if you started at the head first?
Oh, well, I don't know. I'll take the body, and the head will come next. That's what Harry keeps telling me. So.
When do you want to get back in the ring?
Tomorrow.
That says it all.
Joking either.
Thanks very much. There you have it. We'll be back in a little while. Good on, Sean.
And yeah, you're right, Tony Page. James is ready for more. And speaking of ready for more action to follow. That man coming up next, John Duddy. He is ready and rearing to go. We'll be back in New York City after this. Stay with us.
Mrs. Wilson, Credit Guard of America is able to cut your monthly credit card payments by $248.
Mr. Lynch, it looks like you'll be able to save over $13,000 in interest payments with Credit Guard of America.
Credit Guard of America is a nonprofit credit counseling company.
We're here to help you solve your credit problems and meet your financial goals.
Take this important first step toward financial freedom and call Credit Guard of America. Certified credit counselors are standing by right now.
If you are $3,000 or more in debt and 30 days behind in payments, we can help you. So call our toll-free number.
Our certified credit counselors are standing by to provide you with free credit counseling services and assist you in becoming debt-free.
Take this important first step toward financial freedom right now and call Credit Guard of America. Certified credit counselors are standing by right now. Call Credit Guard of America.
We can assist you in becoming debt-free.
welcome back to the world's most famous arena. We are just moments away from the feature bout of the evening. Ireland's John Duddy taking on Shelby Pudwill. Let's take a closer look now at Ireland's John Duddy.
Robinson has been described as the greatest fighter pound for pound in the history of the ring.
When middleweight John Duddy came to the United States from Ireland, he had a dream of making it in the sport of professional boxing. He knew of the storied history of boxing at Madison Square Garden, but his goal wasn't just to be a student of the game, but to make some history in his own right.
I have a library of videotapes back home in Ireland, at my home, from fights of Joe Lewis, the Jake LaMotta, the Sugar Ray Robinson, the Muhammad Ali, like, and the Garden. Like, there was a guy from Scotland, Cam Buchanan, who fought Roberto Duran in the Garden as well. No fights they got there, and they actually believe that I was in the same arena as Emmons, and now I'm heading the show.
Your winner by way of technical knockout, Ireland's John Duddy.
Friends and family back home, like, everybody, even in Ireland, like, they've all been big boxing fans. Like, they know Madison Square Garden, boxing, that's it. I know basketball here and hockey here and all. You mention the Garden, anybody in Ireland, boxing, that's what they think. If you're fighting in Madison Square Garden, I think it's the holy grail of boxing.
Duddy knows to be successful in boxing, hard work is the daily diet served over and over. His attention to detail, his ability to learn, and his desire to absorb data makes John Duddy a prospect with a punch, a following, and a huge upside.
I was an amateur for 14 years, so it was kind of like, you know, still stuck in the one spot. And then I traveled here a few times with the Irish team, and I seen how the American teams train, and the coaches, and the styles. And New York is second to none in the world for that. And when I came here, it was like a kid walking into a candy store. So it was, because everybody I met, my first day in Gleason's gym, I met Wayne Braithwaite, Saab Judah, Vivian Harris. No, I was like, these guys train here like everybody else, and that's where I want to be in their position, you know.
Bow, bow, bow. You down low, ready to, there's no need for you to drop your hands. So if you go here, your hands gotta be here.
The success rate of my fights, since I've met my coach Harry Kite, the way that he's been able to exploit certain aspects of my style to the maximum, which has never been exploited before in my amateur days, you know, where planting my feet, you know, setting my shots, picking my punches, moving my head a lot more, working the body more. And it's all the basics, you know, working over again, just the small things. They're not simple by no means, but it's a very start. Wee things that people tend to can overlook. And we started, like, whenever I came here, Harry asked me, can you throw a jab? And I says, I don't know. And he says, you've been an amateur 14 years and you don't know if you can throw a jab. I says, I don't know if I can throw your jab. I says, you tell me what to do and I'll try and do it. And that's just the relationship that I have with him, because I know everything that he's telling me is for the best for me. It's like a dream come true, and when they look at it, you go, John Duddy's fighting in Madison Square Garden. No, and the fact that they've probably never seen it before, bar on TV, you know, like, he's fighting there. I think it's hard for people to grasp, but there's a lot of family and friends coming from Ireland for this fight. So I think whenever they get there, they'll get the full impact of where I've actually landed and how I'm actually doing. I'm really excited. I never thought that something like this would ever happen to me. I think in my wildest dreams, you know, and so early in my career as well, to be actually headlining a show in the MSG. And I'm as hungry as ever, and I'm really looking forward to hopefully putting on a fight and a show that's worthy of being in Madison Square Garden.
And John Duddy is fighting in Madison Square Garden. We are in the theater of Madison Square Garden. And tonight he's facing Shelby Pudwill. Well, all this play for John Duddy, Shelby Pudwill has got to be thinking upset on his mind. Shelby Pudwill from Mandan, North Dakota. He said he got into boxing when he was 5 years old. His grandfather owned a gym. His grandfather, Buckley, his father, Terry, also worked out in the gym. So he says he's been around the fight game for most of his life. 21-2, one draw with 9 KOs for Shelby Pudwill. And there he comes in, the crowd greets him. Shelby Pudwill has his fight face on. He's got a bandana on his head tied up. Ready to go to work.
He's coming into the devil's den though, Sean.
Oh, yeah. And you will hear this crowd when John Duddy appears. And you'll hear the bagpipes when John Duddy appears. And they'll fly the Irish flag. Shelby Pudwill. Duddy, as an amateur, he was a counterpuncher. Now he's more of an aggressive fighter. And certainly taking his time to get in the ring.
Everybody's getting their riders up now,
sir. Yeah, exactly. It is St. Patrick's Day. And here he comes. We knew he was in there somewhere. From Derry in North Ireland. Said in the pre-fight thoughts, I'm just thinking about getting the job done. Concentrating on his fight plan. He's saying, let's get it on right now. Let's get it going. I want to fight early and open it up. Get the crowd into it. Very exciting. John Duddy. I think the crowd is certainly into it. What do you think?
This place is electric right now, Sean. They just want to see a good fight. I'm sure they're going to get a good fight, I'm sure.
Listen to that crowd.
This place is electric right now.
They're having a ball. I think we're all ready. Bagpipes are playing. They're coming in the ring. Let's go up to Joe Antonacci to introduce these fighters.
Ladies and gentlemen, Irish Ropes Promotion presents live from the theater at Madison Square Garden in New York City on the eve of St. Paddy's Day, our main event of the evening. Our main event sanctioned by the New York State Athletic Commission, Ron Scott Stevens, Chairman. Our main event is scheduled for 10 rounds of action for the WBC Continental America's Middleweight Championship. Judges overseeing our main event, Fred Ucci, Dick Flaherty, and Tommy Kazmarek. And a referee for our main event will be Wayne Kelly. Introducing first in the blue corner, he comes to us tonight all the way from Mandan, North Dakota. He weighed in at 158.5 pounds, wears red, white, and blue trunks. Excellent professional record, 21 victories, only 2 defeats, 9 big knockouts. Please welcome Shelby Showtime Pudwill. He weighed in at 160 pounds. Green trunks, gold trim, perfect professional record, 15 victories, no defeats, 13 knockouts. Please welcome Ireland's John Duddy.
John Duddy says, I fight for me fans as much as I fight for myself. He likes to heat it up. He loves to get the crowd into the fight, and that's what he's going to try to do. For Shelby Pudwill, he's got to take the crowd out of this fight, don't you think?
I think so. I think Pudwill's going to stay on his ground and not let him get pushed around, not get pushed around the first couple of rounds.
Well, you know, you're not going to have to look for John Duddy. He's an aggressive fighter. He says in the ring, I'm very aggressive. I'm explosive, too, in the ring. He says my best punch is a left hook. He's naturally right-handed. And he fights from the right-handed stance. And he is, look at this, big left hook. The big left hook. Right in the first round. And he is out. Pudwill is O-U-T. That's all. They should stop this fight. Even the leg of Pudwill. The pet leg, whenever you get knocked out, your legs go to sleep. Look at this. Pudwill still hurt. On the attack of John Duddy. Duddy trying to end it right here. The crowd is into this fight.
He's hurt bad.
As is Duddy. He's hurt. Pudwill is really hurt. Crowd singing. Down for the second time, Shelby Pudwill. Not wasting any time, John Duddy goes right to work.
Seven!
He beat the count, I tell you, Pudwill is tough.
I'll tell you, he just doesn't stop. This is unbelievable.
Look at that, that's all, it's over. Big right hand, and that was it. Pudwill cut, a little bit of blood over the left of the right eye. Pudwell's out of this fight, and John Duddy celebrates with his fans. Happy St. Patrick's Day.
What a display, Sean. That was incredible. This kid is the real deal, Sean.
He's got the goods. Yep. I was really anxious to see him tonight, to see how he reacted with all of the ancillary stuff going on here. And he was focused. He was compact. He didn't waste any of his punches. He didn't waste at all. He went in for the knockout, and he got it over with.
Right, Sean. He went in for the knockout, but he went out in a smart way when after. He didn't go out wild. He went out there and fought his fight. Constant pressure.
I talked about before, too, Mickey. You got the power of the heavyweights and the speed of the lighter weights, and that's what John Duddy possesses. The big right hand. He's got a good left hook. He puts them together, and they're going down.
Exactly. When he throws that right hand, he's always coming back to a hard left hook, vice versa.
The second knockdown, it was Duddy wasting no time on the attack. Down goes Pudwill.
Coming right in.
And Pudwill still not recovered from that first knockdown. Even there, the left hook kind of accentuated it.
He just went
into this fight. The big right hand, and that's it. That's all. Three knockdown rule. It's done. Right hand over the top, hit him on the temple. Down to the canvas goes Shelby.
We see a star in the making, Sean.
That's him. There he is, John Duddy. The crowd loves him. And we love him. Let's listen
Boxing
to Joe Antonacci. Jim Mozell and some of the other team. That's Harry Kite, who has been training him here in the United States, showing him some more aggressive moves and some professional maneuvers.
What a great
they
got
to be happy in that corner.
Great fight to finish the night, Sean. Great
oh,
fight.
Yeah.
It wasn't long, but it was fast.
Great for John Duddy. John Duddy loves it. The crowd loves him. And we're going to come back and listen to what John Duddy has to say just after this. We'll send Tony Page up there. Stay with us.
Are you paying too much for hospital and medical bills? Are you without health insurance, dental, or prescription coverage? Then you need to know about Qualified Health, a nationwide non-insurance medical discount plan that can save you hundreds of dollars on doctor visits, surgery, hospital stays, dental, vision, lab work, and prescription. There's even a 24-hour registered nurse hotline to answer your medical questions. All of this is yours for less than $3 a day. There are no deductibles or restrictions, regardless of your current health condition or citizenship status.
When I was recently hospitalized, Qualified Health helped me save 96% off my hospital bill. 96%.
This past year, I saved 70% of my lab work bills.
I saved 65% of my prescriptions. Qualified Health is amazing.
For more information or to become a member, call this number. Call in the next 10 minutes and receive 1 month free with a year's membership. Call Qualified Health right now. 1-888-600-6006. That's 1-888-600-6006. Or log on to QHealth.com. Get peace of mind for less than $3 a day. Qualified Health.
No crunches ever.
Introducing the Ab Lounge, scientifically designed to get you up off the floor, making old-fashioned crunches a thing of the past.
Sculpt your abdominals using the Ab Lounge jackknife, proven in university testing to be better for your body.
It's as easy as a crunch, but the Ab Lounge design makes every move really count, targeting your abs without wasted effort.
Compare the Ab Lounge to an old-fashioned crunch. The advanced Ab Lounge jackknife generates up to 75% more muscle activity in the upper and lower abdominals, and an amazing 268% more in the love handle obliques.
I have this one pair of jeans. After just 8 weeks, my fat jeans don't really fit anymore.
With its rolled steel frame, the Ab Lounge supports up to 275 pounds.
And it's so easy, almost anyone can use it.
Call now to try the Ab Lounge for 30 days for just $14.95. If you don't agree the Ab Lounge is the best way to a sexy stomach, return it within 30 days for a refund of your $14.95.
Call now and say goodbye to crunches forever.
At the end of the day, nothing matters. The only thing that matters in this sport is inside the ring. You know what I mean? If I don't keep doing what I'm doing now, the crowd isn't going to be here. And because I'm doing it, because of the success in the ring, I've got the fans coming out and supporting me. And without them, it's like it wouldn't mean nothing. They've lifted me to a level in my life that I never thought I'd ever be in before.
Nice performance. You went right through them. How far are you ready before you make your name known in the top 10?
I'm not too sure. I take it a fight at a time. I don't see any reason why they change that now. We're in with a good opponent tonight. He had more fights than me, had more victories than me, and he had a lot of experience, and look what I've done to him. And it's all small steps, you know what I mean? And the next fight I have, I'll be harder again. And Harry keeps training us hard in the gym, so he makes the fight easy. That's exactly what he said to me before we came out here. He's had me out in Rockaway with a sledgehammer and a lorry tire after all my training sessions. And this is what happens. This makes the fight easy.
What happens with hard work.
Yep.
Let's send it down the ringside to Sean O'Grady.
Oh, yeah. John Duddy. Thank you, Tony. A star in the making. He is really grateful for the support that he gets. And we'll be back at the theater in Madison Square Garden to wrap this up. How about that? John Duddy gets the victory, and the fans love him.
Want to take a half-court shot at the Garden for $100,000? Just send a non-winning New York State Lottery ticket to this address. Then watch the Knicks Magic game on MSG March 22nd. If your name comes up, you win two tickets to an upcoming Knicks game. The first winner to call the MSG hotline also wins a luxury suite to a Knicks game and qualifies you for the grand prize. A half-court shot for $100,000. Go to 1050ESPNRadio.com or NYKnicks.com for more information.
What are you setting your sights on? And when you see it, will you be ready? Just pick up the phone, dial 1-800-645-ARMY, and you'll get this free DVD. You'll learn about the hundreds of opportunities the Army can offer you. Skills, education, health care. Call 1-800-645-ARMY, and you'll also get this free boonie hat. Whatever you're looking for, the Army can help you find it.
Diamonds, the jewelry factory, has thousands for every budget. 1 carat solitaires, $5.99. 1 carat ISI diamonds, $2,900. And exotic D flawless and large fancies at low prices. Buy factory direct and save. The jewelry factory in Hackensack.
Back to the theater in Madison Square Garden, where we have seen some exciting boxing. On this St. Patrick's Day, crowd still buzzing about that last bout. But early tonight, we really got to look at some exciting young fighters as take a look at some of the river dancing and the Irish dancing flogging here inside the ring. It was Peter Quillin who went on the attack early in this. The former New York Rolling Gloves champion took care of business. Joe Greene a little bit later. Did not know how to back up, and he ran his record to 9-0 with 8 KOs. It was Maureen Shea being accompanied in by the Bagpipes, and Maureen Shea showed why she is running her record to 5-0. James Moore, a stablemate to John Duddy, got the knockout victory in a fast way, and then our main bout tonight, John Duddy. The excitement of this sport is to watch a young fighter coming up in the world of boxing, somebody to cheer for, somebody to pull for, and John Duddy is quite the guy. It's going to be fun to watch his progress. For Mickey Ward and Tony Page, I'm Sean O'Grady saying, Happy St. Paddy's Day from New York City.
You know, ever since Stang Chili, the chili chili lovers love, became the official chili of Madison Square Garden, it's really taken off. Stang Chili, the official chili of Madison Square Garden.
New York's starting lineup is 1050 ESPN Radio. The opinions start now. Mike and Mike in the morning. The Herd with Colin Cowherd. Lunch with Stephen A. Smith. The Dan Patrick Show. Afternoons with Michael Kay, Max Kellerman. And the Jim Rome Show. The radio home for the New York Knicks, New York Jets, and New York Rangers. New York's starting lineup is 1050 ESPN Radio.
Gear up for select Rangers home games on MSG with the RE/MAX Rangers Tailgate Show. Get the feeling of being at the Garden with host Bob Wischusen, Rangers alumni, and your family of diehard Rangers fans. The RE/MAX Rangers Tailgate Show on MSG.
Great news, Mrs. Wilson. Credit Guard of America is able to cut your monthly credit card payments by $248.
Mr. Lynch, it looks like you'll be able to save over $13,000 in interest payments with Credit Guard of America.
Credit Guard of America is a nonprofit credit counseling company.
We're here to help you solve your credit problems and meet your financial goals.
Take this important first step toward financial freedom and call Credit Guard of America. Certified credit counselors are standing by right now.
If you are $3,000 or more in debt and 30 days behind in payments, we can help you. So call our toll-free number.
Our certified credit counselors are standing by to provide you with free credit counseling services and assist you in becoming debt-free.
Take this important first step toward financial freedom right now and call Credit Guard of America. Certified credit counselors are standing by right now. Call Credit Guard of America.
We can assist you in becoming debt-free.